And the Bible says there's no law against those.
That's right.
There's no law against love.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the name of Jesus.
That perfect.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord Jesus. The Bible says, though I speak the tongue of men and angels.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I have not charity. Though I have prophecy.
Yes.
And I give my body to be burned.
Yes.
You know, I think about that, you know, because you know these people are Muslim. They blow themselves. Mm. And they think they get it somewhere.
Alright.
They give their body to be burned.
Yes.
It doesn't mean nothing.
That's right.
The Bible says it doesn't mean nothing. Hallelujah. Charity is the perfect love of God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God, Jesus.
Praise
Hallelujah.
God.
I know I'm digressing, but let's just go to Ruth, please, for a little while and see what this mighty woman of God, hallelujah, that has made her put a footmark in the scripture. Praise the Lord, Jesus. In the ages of time, remember this woman. Hallelujah. And we just read, praise the name of the Lord, a few verses from Ruth chapter 1. And it says here, hallelujah!
Thank you, Lord.
And it said, Master, if you was here,
you would not die.
You would not die. In other words, why come so late? Jesus, why come so late? You could have saved him when he was sick. You could have just lay hand on him when he was sick.
Yes.
Praise the name of Jesus. But he did. But he said to him, I am the resurrection.
Right.
And I'm the life.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Go.
Though he is not, he's living.
Yes.
Though he is not dead. Though he is my eye, she shall live.
Yes, shall live.
Yes, shall live.
Yes, shall live.
For Jesus was life. Life. Come on. Hallelujah. Jesus was life.
Still alive.
Hallelujah. And he's still life. Praise the Lord Jesus. The instrument, our mobiles.
Praise the Lord Jesus.
Praise the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Why are we share it with my brethren. I know, many of us have no idea of chains. I've been in chains. But it's horrible.
It's horrible.
You're bound. You have no power over yourself.
No, sir.
You can't even go to the bathroom. We have somebody taking you there.
All right, sir.
You're bound.
Yes.
Praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm just coming down. Just to say this. Hallelujah. Ruth knew the God that Naomi served. And she was determined. Don't bother trying to discourage me. You know, we need a mind made up. Understand this to us, brethren. You know, a lot of you have been a long way walking with the Lord and been seeing all the power of God. I know. Praise the name of Jesus. But you sometimes we take this touch. Praise the name of Jesus. But it's not the God we serve.
Amen.
He's able to deliver.
Yes,
he's able to bring us out. Praise Jesus. For the condition. To us, who saw me. That this was the true God. She said, I want it. She did not give you. No, I'm my neighbor. I'm going with you. I'm going to be with you and your people. I'm going to be with you and your God. I'm going to worship with you and your God. Praise the name of Jesus. Because there's no other way. There's no other God. Praise the name of Jesus. My brethren, I just want to encourage you. I mean, there's so much to say. I'm coming down. There's so much to say. By the time we live in him, it's a very crucial time.
Yes.
And I think sometimes I wonder if some of us in the church are awake to what's happening right now in the world. Revelation is opening up right now in front of our eyes like a book. And the things that are happening in the world now will make you tremble. Because we reach the threshold. And we're reaching the time when it becomes, it's a one man government. One man currency. One world government. They implemented that right now as I speak. And a lot of people are not aware of it. We are looking at Revelation unfolding right in front of our eyes. So it's a tremendous, exciting time for Christians.
Amen.
It's a tremendously exciting time for Christians. And my brethren, let us stand up flat-footed. Let us stand up flat-footed. Praise the name of Jesus. Because we cannot pray away what is coming. We cannot pray it away.
That's right.
Because the Bible tells us it's going to happen. We cannot pray it away. Or we can be, the Bible says, finally, Jesus said, when you see all these things come to pass, look up.
Yeah.
That's my thought to us today.
Yeah, bless you.